Thank you for the invitation. My topic is to find with you the more legal framework for Gaia X. This is my conviction, not only because I'm Professor of Law, nobody is perfect, but also because Europe has been built on the very strong principle of rule of law. The European Court of Justice continues to say it regularly. In the European Union, the principal legal requirement is the respect of rule of law. As in the US, in Europe, the rule of law is the respect of individuals and the application of judicial review. This is the most important of everything. This basis is developed by the European Parliament, the European Commission and the Court of Justice. The European Union is also built on some substantial legal principles, such as the free competition principles and the compliance principles. Compliance law is a new branch of law, very powerful, a sort of alliance between public authorities and private enterprises. Compliance law increases very fast in US and in Europe. The future of Europe may be in this very new branch of law, compliance law. This is a legal way for an autonomous Europe. This new branch of law will be very adequate for Gaia X, I'm sure of that, and I would like to express it. Firstly, by explaining what is compliance law by giving a definition. Secondly, by exposing how compliance law works. Thirdly, by showing what European compliance law works already, because it does. Quarterly, by showing how this new European compliance law will be adequate for Gaia X. What is compliance law? Compliance law is a very new branch of law, a new form of regulatory law. So both are ex ante branch of law, while competition law remain an ex post branch of law. As regulatory law does, compliance law expresses very ambitious goals, the monumental goals going beyond the simple efficient functionings of markets. These monumental goals may be the prevention of systemic risk, as in banking and financial catastrophic failures in banking and financial LVI systems. It could be also the prevention of system global crimes, such as corruption or money laundering. These sort of monumental goals are negative. The goal is to block even in the future, to block the failure, to block the corruption, and so on. But Europe, with private enterprises, supports not only this category of negative monumental goals, but supports also some positive monumental goals, which are also very ambitious, maybe more. In ex ante, protecting nature. In ex ante, protecting individuals through personal data compliance law. In ex ante, making human beings concretely equal. For instance, between men and human, for example, right? Only for example. In ex ante, obtaining innovation for everyone. In ex ante, giving autonomy to a geographical zone. An autonomy in the duration, a stable autonomy built by Europe to Europe in the benefit of everyone, in benefit for everyone. For obtaining that, compliance law puts in balance free market, simple free market goals, and these negative and positive monumental goals in a competitive context with ex ante legal compliance tool. This is how compliance tool functions. How does compliance law work? The most important being these monumental goals, the legal reasoning must start from these goals. This is why it is essential and legally required, first of all, to express these goals very precisely. After that, in a second step, the legal and technical means are put in place to reach these monumental goals. The question is how and where organize this compliance tool with efficiency. The solution is to choose those organizations, public or private, which are in the best position to do so, and let them. They are the crucial enterprises. The notion of crucial enterprises is central in regulatory law and compliance law. For instance, banks and financial institutions are the crucial enterprises in the prevention of corruption. This is why banks and financial enterprises organize the means to which the monopoly goal blocks the corruption by the obtention of information, by the creation of information but for this purpose, by the centralization of information, by the transmission of information. Compliance law is, first of all, a law of information. Information as a tool to reach a monumental goal. This is a part of work for the private bodies. But where are the public bodies? They are everywhere. And they must be, because, as we know, information is a common good. Public bodies work as supervisory bodies on these private operators, which must be powerful to reach that monumental goal, but also must be supervised. This is why private bodies must be transparent, not for their competitors, must be accountable for this supervisor, not for their competitors, must exercise their power in proportion with the monumental goal. The supervisory public body exercises the proportionality control. This is how compliance law works and must work. European compliance law already works. Today, the European Union's compliance law works and works very well. It is an example for the others, even for the US, as we can observe. About the personal data protection, this compliance law mechanism created in Europe. At the beginning in France in 1978 and in Germany, and after that in the European Union compliance law, at the beginning by case law in the jurisprudence of the Court of Justice in 2014 and by the very famous GDPR in 2017. Its monumental goal is the protection of the individuals. This protection of the individuals is another goal than the protection of the market. It has been created by the Court of Justice through the pure creation of the right to be forgotten without any specific regulation. The GDPR came after this first judgment adopted in 2014 by the Court against Google Spain. This goal of protecting individuals has been internalized into enterprises in Europe and might be supported by regulation, but it is also and after that supported by its general goals based on the rule of law. It is easy to see it through the two also very famous judgments adopted by the Court of Justice, Schrems 1 and Schrems 2, which block the extraterritorial transmission of personal data from Europe to US. Let's go to another European example. The monumental goal of the prevention of systemic failures in banking economy, obtaining European economic stability. This is the monumental goal visited by the European Banking Union, established in 2014. It works very well. This goal has been internalized in the crucial enterprises, which are banks. These banks, which are crucial enterprises, are supervised by the European Supervisory Board, Department of the European Central Bank. All work in ex ante. This constitutes a very pertinent model. Looking at the European legal evolution, we can say that Europe is moving from competition as unique principle to regulatory and compliance pillar. By this balance between competition and compliance, These monumental goals may be reached by ex ante compliance tool, first of all based on information and rule of law. Not only for negative monumental goals, banking union, but also for positive monumental goals, protective of human beings, personal data, protective nature, protective on innovation, which are the identity of Europe, stability, protection of the future. For obtaining that, so important but so difficult, the European public bodies let private enterprises organize themselves the means and supervise them. We can take other ingoing and some example, very important. For example, in agricultural area, with the European project From Farm to Fork, in health area, with crucial information platforms. For every topic, and not only about regulated sectors, everyone observes a European mutation, which can be expressed like that. From an ex-post European by competition law to an ex-ante Europe by regulatory law, through an internalization of monumental goal in crucial enterprises by compliance law. The adequacy between compliance law and Gaia X. Staying the project Gaia X in a legal perspective, it is remarkable that this project matches very well with the current principle of the general European compliance law. Gaia X is a private initiative of crucial enterprises to obtain a European data infrastructure built on this goal of autonomy about the essential tool which is data for the industrial creation. Compliance law is an ex-ante branch of law which supports the private enterprises and controls the use they do of their CIS powers in direction of the monumental goals. This control must be very strict and the accountability must be very effective. Compliance law must support the creation by private enterprises of new tools to reach monumental goals, negative or positive. Gaia X needs the legal support with the legal framework of control. In this case, Gaia X has a monumental goal, the creation of the European data infrastructure, giving the autonomy to Europe. This is a positive monumental goal. Gaia X must always demonstrate the reality of this monumental goal. It must not be just a speech, a rhetoric conduct. This is why permanently the governance of Gaia X must give to see the tools put in place and used to reach this monumental goal. The concrete legal organization of control must be built for and on three principles used in compliance law for everyone, public or private bodies, to have in command and always in mind. The monumental goals give a European autonomy through the data infrastructure. Explicit monumental goals make regular reports, annual reports for example, of the concretization of these monumental goals. For private enterprises, organize by themselves all means required to reach these monumental goals. Be always transparent for the supervisory board, but not for the competitors. No. Compliance is not free lunch. Report to this public supervisory board, regulatory or on requirement. Organize, for instance, a system of alert for the stakeholders. This is a part for private bodies and for public bodies. Organize a general supervisory mechanism. Organize a regular hearings on the board of Gaia X through a specific supervisory bodies, maybe as in it was made by the banking union, or a specific power given to the European Commission, for example, could be, and with specific powers, such as specific power to require information at any moment from Gaia X, of course, everything may be adjusted. The most important is to use this wonderful new branch of law, which is compliance law, to obtain the best relation between public and private entities for creating in ex ante the autonomous Europe. It could be my conclusion. For Gaia X, let's go into European compliance law.